me told. One of the lucky ones who's made his name. One day they'll make you glorious beneath the lights of your deserved fame.
One of the most exciting players still I've ever seen. He used to be standing in the shed and shooting up, coming down that right flank.
Great.
Obviously, inconsistencies that you get with winners, but to be up here on the big occasion,
well, often
the
team used to be coming up. Wasn't it a bad shot?
Yeah. Yeah, normally produce the goods on the big occasion.
Yeah. No, for sure. Absolutely for sure. Especially on the big nights. There's no better sight under the floodlights than this midweek. And Rob, going through that hill in the second half.
Yeah.
That was awesome, awesome. Awesome sight.
We were the ones who saw you first of all. We always knew that you were one of the brightest stars.
In your early teens, going along to watch Dundee United and seeing guys like Ralph Milne, he's just electric pace. Great with the ball at his feet, and he scored, usually his goals were spectacular, and when you're a young guy, when you just look up to guys like that, and he lived the dream that we all possess, I think, of being a guy, a local guy, playing for your local team and reaching the heights.
Because I didn't think I would recognise him. I haven't seen him for a long, long time. And it was great, you know. And it was like you'd met each other yesterday type thing, you know. Whether you're 30 years apart, you're just the same, still my manager as such, you know. A terrific guy, you know.
That's some of the pitches that we used to play, huh?
Eh? Yeah.
How old is your young lad, Ralph?
Bradley would be 22.
Did any of them play football like yourself?
No.
No, I didn't.
No. Bradley would be 22 this month.
Yeah.
And Robert's 19.
Yeah.
He's doing Bristol with his mum.
Ah, good, good. So you've had a varied career. Look, kept track of a wee bit, you know what I mean? Moving through here to there and everywhere, you know? I didn't ken you were so long at Man United, so. What was it, about 2.5, 3 years?
2.5 years, I played in the first team for the season I went there.
But you met a lot of worries, eh? That's good, though.
But I knew at the end of that season there'd be new players coming in.
That's right.
Great days, yeah.
Oh, great days, right?
Some club, unbelievable.
It's a big club, isn't it? It's one of the biggest in the world.
It probably is.
Like this pitch here, I was freezing. Hey, day we were playing. So dirty here, running up these strips, waving it. It's no cold. No, boy, you're going to be like that. You couldn't work because your feet were freezing. Okay. The time you were late here. It was quite an hour before the time. He wasn't here, he didn't get to play. And I said, Ralph's not here. I said, oh, it'll be a good thing. Ralph's not here. And just as I seen him coming, I said, you've got 50 seconds to get here.
Did I make it?
You made it. What had he been 20 seconds away? He's still playing.
Dodgy watch.
Ralph wanted the forward line all his self. He didn't want names the other side of him. Jimmy Carr, get away, get you the road. I went. So we had McPhee in Framingham, they could just ping the ball him and he was ready like a shot. Greedy, but that's what a striker should be. You know, and he was like, you wanting the ball, no wanting McDonough, you wanting McCarr on the side of you. Yeah, that's right. Scored a lot of goals, eh? And very, very seldom injured when he was younger. Had no problems, you know, under 11, right up to United, no problems at all. That's what's about, isn't it? Okay, we're good times.
my father left me to my own devices, if you like. He never interfered, but he was immensely proud when I signed schoolboy forms for Dundee United. And my mother, well, my mother had four kids, so she had to look after them all, so there was no airs and graces with my mum. You know, she'd looked after us, you know. My father went up and bought a load of booze and had it on the table when the Dundee United manager came in with his two scouts, and my father offered him a drink, and I said, no, we don't drink. And I'm like, oh, I don't believe you've done this, Dad, you know. But, well, we had a laugh about it afterwards, huh? But he was immensely proud.
Football to the city of Dundee really is a huge passion. We've got two clubs here, Dundee FC and Dundee United. And when we were all at school growing up, you picked one or the other. For me, it was Dundee United. And we were fortunate that by the late 70s, Dundee United were becoming a force in football. And they brought together a team with a manager, Jim McLean. They were really a force to be reckoned with by then. And it culminated in the League One in 1983. And some of the stars of that team, they were all stars, but guys like Paul Hegarty, Paul Sturrock, Ralph Mullen, but they were a great unit. And for a provincial club like Dundee United to win the league, who knows if I'll ever be repeated again, but that was a fantastic feat.
You all needed each other, so you couldn't fall out with each other. And I think that was the key to success, you know. I mean, it was like us against the manager, but he, in a certain way, wanted it that way. So you've got a group of players that are going to fight together, and that's, well, it worked, didn't it?
The whole season of 1982-83, the team were going well, and they were up there challenging with Aberdeen and Celtic, and it came to... You couldn't have scripted it better to play against your local rivals, Dundee, on their turf at Dens Park on the 14th of May 1983. And you could ask any Dundee United fan in the town, that was a defining moment.
Just to have the sort of the nerves to do what you'd done at that moment.
I mean, it was really United's first strike at goal, and I thought, I remember being behind it thinking, this is unbelievable effort, but it's going to go over.
It was a magnificent moment in history looking back, but at the time, it was no more than what we kind of expected.
Probably 25,000 arms in the place. To get the ball where he'd done, just a couple of shimmies and then chipped pretty much 25 yards over the keeper. Just in that theatre, it was absolutely fantastic.
Richard Gawkins, side of the fence. Milne. Wriggles clear. Might just get the chip and he does, he scores!
A defining moment in my career, really. I mean, everybody, all the Dundee United supporters, remember it forever. And then we got a penalty just after about 10 minutes, 12 minutes. And Eamon Barron took it, and their keepers saved it, but Eamon got the rebound and put it in, we were 2-0 up. And then Dundee scored, and it was 2-1 at half time. And the game was really a very good game, but we held on well to win the league, and it was just an amazing atmosphere here. Fantastic.